The Devil's Rejects, probably one of my favorite horror movies of all time. Most people would agree that out of all of Rob Zombie's movies, that this is his best work. Filmed in just 30 days in 2005, it is not only the best Rob Zombie has to offer, it is probably one of the best horror movies in the last 10 to 15 years. I love this intro. It's probably one of my favorite movie opening scenes of all time as well. Hell, you have to love the Firefly family. You have Otis, the deranged killer.
I am the devil, and I am here to do the devil's work.
This movie has it all. Gore, blood, psychological elements, and even a little bit of comedy. What more could you want? You have Baby, who lures people in so that the Firefly family can have their way with them.
My doctor says I got lungs like a professional athlete.
I get it. You want to live forever.
Yeah.
So what are you, on vacation all by yourself or something?
No. I'm actually out here.
Speaking of likable, how could you not love Sid Haig as Captain Spaulding? This scene is one of my favorite scenes of all time.
Yeah, clown. Uh-huh. Oh, hi.
I'm going to have to be taking your car today. See, I have some top secret clown business that supersedes any plans that you might have for this here vehicle.
What's that about clown business?
Last stutter, bitch.
Jamie, get in the car. Lock the door.
Where the hell are you going, Kevin? Don't you never turn your back on a fucking clown when he's talking to you.
Fucking hands off of me!
What's the matter, kid? Don't you like clowns? Why? Don't we make you laugh? Aren't we fucking funny? You best come up with an answer, because I'm gonna come back here and check on you and your mama. If you ain't got a reason why you hate clowns, I'm gonna kill your whole fucking family. All right, now get your fucking ass out the car. Come on. Yeah. Woo!
You look at these people and think they're the most evil motherfuckers in the world, but yet you can't help cheering for them. After all, they're just here to do the devil's work.
Bullshit. You know, I trust that fucker Charlie about as much as I trust you.
Where the hell did you get all fucking shit about Charlie?
Hey, I know what I know, and I know I don't like that nutsack.
Well, unless you got a better suggestion, I suggest you keep your fucking pie holes shut. That is the only remotely safe place I know about.
Hey man, if anyone's interested, I think I'm gonna be wanting some ice cream in about 10 miles.
Hey man, I think I'm gonna be wanting some ice cream in about 10 miles.
Don't you fucking imitate me, it's fucking rude. You know what I know, and I know I don't like that nutsack.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
2 fucking seconds for the kid, is that gonna kill you?
Yes, it is gonna kill me. I have calculated the time, and 2 seconds is the exact amount of time that's a hazard to my fucking health.
Come on, don't be such a fucking drag, I'm starving.
Hey, eat this.
What is your fucking problem? I'm in and out in 2 seconds.
You know, I think I'm gonna get me some Tutti fucking Frutti.
Tutti fucking Frutti, that sounds good.
Tutti fucking Frutti.
Shut up.
Tutti fucking Frutti. Tutti fucking Frutti.
Shut up.
Tutti fucking Frutti.
Listen, there is no fucking ice cream in your fucking future.
What is most surprising to me is that Rob Zombie has not came out with a film nearly as good as this one in a long time, with maybe the Halloween remakes being the exception. These are characters that people love, even if they are true psychopathic murderers. Overall, The Devil's Rejects is definitely in my top 10 best of all time. Sure, there are probably several other horror movies worthy of that title, but I think this one is more than deserving. Rumor is that Rob Zombie is producing a sequel to this movie after nearly 13 years. Although it's only a rumor, I would think that it would be a prequel. But with how weird most of his movies have been lately, you never know who might get resurrected. If you do not already have this one in your collection, I would definitely pick it up. I could go on for days and days about this movie, how much I love it, specific scenes, but that would take too long. I think you should definitely pick this up, no matter when, where, or how. Add it to your collection. It's definitely one of those movies you'll watch again and again, time and time again. This has been a Die Laughing Studios movie review. Thanks for watching.